Hello everyone, in the last videos we have seen what is a computer network and OS reference model. In this video lecture we'll start with module 1, that is application layer. I, Professor Manjunath Patil, welcome you all for this video lecture. The objectives of this module are, you will learn about principles of network applications, application layer protocols, the web and HTTP, file transfer, electronic mail in the internet, then DNS and socket programming. First, we will see what are the principles of network applications. Suppose you have an idea for new network applications and you want to develop this application. How you are going to develop this application? Let's now examine how you translate this idea into the real world network application. At the core of a network application development is writing programs that run on different end systems and communicate with each other over the network. For example, in the web application, there are two distinct programs that communicate with each other. The browser program running in the user's host. The user's host like a desktop, laptops, tablets, smartphones and so on. And the web server program running in the web server host. Thus, when developing your new application, you need to write a software that will run on multiple end systems. So this software could be written in C programming, Java programming or Python programming. Now we'll see the network application architectures. So before developing any applications, first we need to understand the architectures. The application architectures is distinctly different from the network architectures, that is OSI reference model. As discussed in the previous video, to see this video lecture, click on this I button. From the application developer's perspective, the network architecture is fixed and provides a specific set of services to applications. Whereas the application architectures, on the other hand, is designed by application developer and dictates how the application is structured over the various end systems. There are two application architectures. They are client server architecture and the peer to peer architecture. First one, the client server architecture. There is an always on host called the server, which services a request from many other hosts called clients. A classic example is the web application, for which an always on web server services request from a browsers running on a different client host. When a web server receives a request for an object from a client host, it responds by sending the requested object to the client host. The client server architecture is that the server has a fixed well-known address called IP address, which we will see in other video. The server has a fixed well-known address, and because the server is always on and a client can always contact the server by sending a packet to the server's IP address. So hence the server IP address should be fixed. Some of the better known applications with the client server architectures include web, FTP and email. Often in a client server applications, a single server host is incapable of keeping up with all the requests from clients. For example, a popular social networking site like Facebook can quickly become overloaded if it has only one server handling all of its requests. For this reason, a data center is often used to create a powerful virtual server. The most popular internet services such as search engines, example Google and Bing, and internet commerce like Amazon and eBay. Web-based email, example Gmail and HaveMail. Social networking like Facebook and Twitter make use of one or more data centers. For example, Google has 30 to 50 data centers distributed around the world, which collectively handles search, YouTube, Gmail, and other services. A data center can have hundreds of thousands of servers, which must be powered and maintained. Now, coming to the another application architecture, that is peer-to-peer architecture. In peer-to-peer architecture, there is minimal or no dependency on dedicated servers in data centers. Instead, the application have direct communication between a pair of connected hosts called peers. The peers are like desktops and laptops controlled by users, with most of the peers residing in home, universities, and offices. Because the peers communicate without passing through a dedicated server, the architecture is called as a peer-to-peer architecture. Many of today's most popular applications are based on peer-to-peer architectures. So these applications include file sharing, example BitTorrent, and internet telephony, example Skype. Some applications may have hybrid architectures combining both client server and peer-to-peer elements. For example, for many instant messaging applications, servers are used to track IP addresses of users that follows client-server architecture, but user-to-user messages are sent directly between the user host without passing through the intermediate servers. So that follows the peer-to-peer architectures. So in this video, we have learned the principles of network architectures, and we have studied the applications architectures. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.